Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lectures, we described bounded and unbounded intervals. Bounded intervals are limited by their endpoints to a finite length on the number line. Bounded intervals can be closed, open, left closed, right open, or left open, right closed. Unbounded intervals can be right unbounded and left closed or open, left unbounded and right closed or open, or unbounded on both ends. These intervals are called proper intervals because they include more than one point. However, not all intervals are proper. It is possible for an interval to include only one point or no points. If the left and right endpoints of a closed interval are the same number, then the interval is called a degenerate interval and represents a single point on the number line. So a degenerate interval is a set which contains one real number. On the other hand, if both endpoints of an open interval are the same, then that interval contains no points, so this interval represents the empty set. When we first introduced interval notation, we said that an interval was a special type of set consisting of a continuous span of numbers on the number line. Mathematicians call this property connectedness. Intervals are the connected sets of the number line. Even though a continuous span is intuitively easy to understand, a mathematician might define the concept of an interval in the following way. An interval is a set of real numbers with the property that any number that lies between two numbers in the set is also included in the set. So the key property of an interval is that no matter which two numbers we pick in the interval, every number between those two numbers must also be contained in the interval. Since the two numbers we pick can be as close as we like to the endpoints, no numbers which lie between the endpoints can be excluded from the interval. Therefore, every number between the two endpoints of an interval must be included in the interval. This property is true whether the endpoints are included in the interval or not included. For unbounded intervals, since one can pick two numbers arbitrarily far apart, all real numbers must be included in the interval. This definition is useful for testing if a set of real numbers can be represented by a single interval. For example, let's say that we have a set which consists of 0 and 2 and all numbers in between except the number 1. Using set builder notation, this would be the set of all numbers x such that x is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 2 and not equal to 1. But this set is not an interval. We know this because our definition for intervals says that every number that lies between any two numbers in the set must also be included in the set. However, the number 1 lies between numbers in this set, but is not included in the set. So this set cannot be described by a single interval. However, sometimes it is easier and more clear to describe regions of the number line like this set using interval notation. This can be accomplished by combining intervals. Since intervals are sets, we can use set operations to combine multiple intervals into one set. For example, we can take the left closed, right open interval between 0 and 1, and the left open, right closed interval between 1 and 2, and take their union to create the desired set. As another example, let's create one set containing all the numbers between 0 and 1 and between 2 and 3, but not including the endpoints. In set builder notation, this is the set of all numbers x such that x is greater than 0 and less than 1 or greater than 2 and less than 3. If we pick one number between 0 and 1, and a second number between 2 and 3, any number between 1 and 2 lies between these two numbers, but is not a member of the set. Therefore, this set cannot be represented by a single interval. However, if we take the open interval between 0 and 1, and the open interval between 2 and 3, then the union of these two intervals creates the desired set. As a final example, let's create a set containing all real numbers except 0. In set builder notation, this is the set containing all numbers x not equal to 0. This set is not an interval, since if we pick any two numbers on either side of 0, both numbers are members of the set, but the number 0, which lies between these two numbers, is not a member of the set. We can represent this set using interval notation by taking the union of the left unbounded interval containing all numbers less than 0 and the right unbounded interval containing all numbers greater than 0. Intervals, which are neither empty nor degenerate, are said to be proper. As we have seen, all proper intervals contain more than one point. If an interval contains more than one point, it must contain an infinite number of points, since between any two distinct points on the number line, there are an infinite number of points. Therefore, all proper intervals are sets containing an infinite number of elements. So far, we have talked about sets of real numbers, and we have seen that these sets can be visualized using the number line. A line is a one-dimensional object, and the number line represents real numbers as points in this one-dimensional space. In the next lecture, we will examine mathematical objects which can be visualized as points in two or more dimensions.